So let's go back to the code we had for extracting the first URL in a page and see how we can turn that into a procedure. And remember, we made many copies of the same code if we wanted to extract many links from the page. What we want to do now is take the part that we kept having to copy, figure out how to turn that into a procedure. So what we want to do is take this code. So we're going to take all the code here. I'm leaving this part out of the procedure because that's what we want to do with the results. What we want to do is take all this code and turn it into a procedure. That means instead of having to do all this work each time, what we want is a procedure that will start from what we have here. We have the page. What we want to do is from the page, do a bunch of work, get the URL. Then we want to do some stuff with the URL. We want to do some stuff with the page. And then we're going to do it all over again. So our goal is to figure out how to turn this part of the code into a procedure so we could keep reusing that each time instead of writing the same code. So we need a little more room. So let's shrink the code we had. And now the question is, how are we going to make that procedure? So let's start with a quiz. When we think about making a procedure, the first thing we always want to do is make sure that we understand this. We need to know what the inputs are to that procedure. We need to know what the outputs are. If we don't understand the inputs and the outputs, then there's no hope of writing the procedure correctly, since the main purpose of the procedure is to map the inputs into the outputs. So let's see if you can figure out what the inputs should be for the procedure that we want to make to replace this code. And I'm going to give the procedure a name. So the goal of the procedure is to find the URL that's the next link target in this page. So we'll call the procedure getNextTarget. It's important to give good names to procedures. That's how we remember what they're supposed to do. And we'll use the name getNextTarget. So our question now is, in defining this procedure, what should its inputs be? I'll give you some choices. So its input could be a number, giving the position of the start of the next link. Its input could be a number, giving the position of the start of the next quote. Its input could be a string, giving the contents of the rest of the web page. And for the final choice, we could have two inputs. The first, a number giving the position of the start of the next link. And the second, a string giving the contents of the page.